Frank Warren in association with FrankWarren.tv and the Queensbury Fight Network proudly presents 12 rounds of 3 minutes duration to decide the welterweight championship of Great Britain live and exclusive on Sky Sports Friday Fight Night. Your officials are appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control, and your three judges at ringside are all from Great Britain. Mr. Richie Davies of All Hallows, Mr. Mark Green of Romford, and Mr. Ian John Lewis of Gillingham. Your board representative is Robert Smith, and when the action begins, your referee in charge of the contest is Mr. Marcus McDonnell of Twickenham. Your timekeeper at the bell is Michael McCann. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, in the red corner, entering the ring with a record of 12 wins from 15 contests, wearing the silver and green shorts. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 10 stone, 6 pounds, 8 ounces. Please welcome from Darlaston in the Midlands, the challenger for the title, Stuart Elwell. And across the ring, this evening stands the champion, wearing the red and white shorts, weighing in at 10 stone, 6 pounds, 12 ounces. He enters the ring with a perfect 18 wins from 18 contests, with 11 of those wins coming inside the distance. Hailed as one of British boxing's next big stars, who tonight is attempting to add his third notch toward his quest for a Lonsdale belt outright. Please welcome from Sheffield in England, the undefeated and reigning welterweight champion of Great Britain, Kell Brook. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Right, guys, I spoke to you both in the press room. You know what I expect. Outlaw professors at all times obey my instructions. Watch your heads, keep it clean. Any questions? Brooke, questions?
Elwood?
Okay, let's go to work.
Let's go on 12 round rounds for the British Welterweight Championship.
So we're about to get underway here in your court. The second defence at Kelbrook in this British Welterweight title. I'm delighted to say, as ever, I'm joined ringside by Colin Mark.
Good evening, Ian, and I'm really looking forward to seeing Cole Brook. I'm very impressed with him in his last two fights when he won the vacant title.
Second down, first round.
Knocked out, knocked him down in 1 round. It's not the fact that he won in 1 round, it's the manner in which he did it. The boy, I think, has got class.
Brook, 66-1 on favourite with the bookies. Is there any chance at the world?
You must give everybody a chance. We've all seen amazing upsets. Only last weekend in America, when Shane Mosley kicked the hair out of Margarito, and nobody thought he was going to do that to Margarito. Oh, he's on the floor immediately to the left hand. Elway.
Push him away, well done.
Yes, exactly. He's not there to hurt, but he's kicked him as he's always moving towards him. And as you say, he's more off balance than hurt. But nevertheless, there's two knockdowns already.
Like a matador, isn't it, Colin? Saw him with a bolt.
I think Elwell's out of his depth here.
Last ten. Brooks' favourite. So far in this first round. Unless he gets very, very careless indeed. Elbrook will be retaining his British welterweight title. Elwell does see it through.
Down twice, so 10-7 round. 10-7, yes. He's got to recover from that. Those two knockdowns, which of course wouldn't have done his confidence any good whatsoever. And he'll be very wary from now on, and he'll be more defensive minded than attack minded as a result of it. But, he's a very sensible guy. I had a long chat with Cole earlier in the week. He knows he's got to be patient. He knows he's got a lot of time in his hands. And what he's hoping for is if James is going to bring the surprise on the 23rd of February against Nicolas Conte, he would love to fight Tekken for the world title later on in the year. But I think that is
round two.
One wish that he's not going to get. It's got to fight the Brook.
It's a fight, isn't it?
Yeah, it would be a British title defence, it wouldn't be a world title defence.
So, round two underway here at York Hall. Very much. Kell Brook's first round, he had our world down twice.
Doesn't move something, but property. Of course, under the old rule, I mean, let's be fair, I've just seen the replay of the stoppage. Every time he got hit by Brooks, he sort of wobbled his legs.
Well, he did. He was doing a funny dance after that little combination there from Kell Brook just before the stoppage. And it was probably a little bit premature, but there was only going to be one.
Saved the inevitable. And, you know, when you think about it, you look at it again, he didn't argue too much, did he?
And he's not argued too much as he's gone back to his corner. And the disappointment on his face is almost the fact that he wasn't in the fight, Colin, isn't it? Rather than being disappointed with the referee. It's just almost a despondency because he knew that he wasn't.
No, I think this boy Brook is something special. I think he looks like he could go a long way. As long as I say, we don't know whether he can take a punch, a real punch. And of course, fighting the Elways of this world is one thing, and
ladies and gentlemen, at 1 minute, 29 seconds of round two, your referee, Marcus McDonald, has stopped the contest. He deemed that Stuart Elwell was in no position to continue. The winner and still the British welterweight champion in the blue corner from Sheffield,